Se io parlo di scie chimiche adesso, viene il CICAP e mi dice che sono un complottista. Adesso vediamo cosa dice il direttore della CIA sulle scie chimiche.
It is indeed a pleasure to be back at the Council to compare notes on a remarkably complex and dynamic international scene. And I very much look forward to talking with Judy and Council membership on the many topics that are in the headlines. Now, whenever I administer the oath of office to new officers at our headquarters in Langley, Virginia, I tell them that they are coming aboard at a critical moment in our agency's history. In the 36 years since I first entered government, I have never been witnessing a time with such a daunting array of challenges to our nation's security. Another example is the array of technologies, often referred to collectively as geoengineering, that potentially could help reverse the warming effects of global climate change. One that has gained my personal attention is stratospheric aerosol injection, or SAI, a method of seeding the stratosphere with particles that can help reflect the sun's heat in much the same way that volcanic eruptions do. An SAI program could limit global temperature increases, reducing some risks associated with higher temperatures and providing the world economy additional time to transition from fossil fuels. This process is also relatively inexpensive. The National Research Council estimates that a fully deployed SAI program would cost about $10 billion yearly. As promising as it may be, moving forward on SAI would also raise a number of challenges for our government and for the international community. On the technical side, greenhouse gas emission reductions would still have to accompany SAI to address other climate change effects, such as ocean acidification, because SAI alone would not remove greenhouse gases from the atmosphere. On the geopolitical side, the technology's potential to alter weather patterns and benefit certain regions of the world at the expense of other regions could trigger sharp opposition by some nations. Others might seize on SAI's benefits and back away from their commitment to carbon dioxide reductions. And as with other breakthrough technologies, global norms and standards are lacking to guide the deployment and implementation of SAI and other geoengineering initiatives. I could go on and on and on and on about the things that fascinate me, but rather than talk about them, I thought it...
Se lo dice Tom Bosco, Fincati, complottisti. Se lo dice il direttore della CIA, non dicono niente. A scuola cosa scrivono? Questo libro scolastico, ragazzi. Pioggia, da dove vieni? Sapevi che l'acqua della pioggia proviene dalla terra? Sono i laghi, i fiumi, gli oceani a dare origine alle piogge. L'acqua deve salire per poter scendere. Quando fa caldo l'acqua sale nell'aria e si dice che evapora, poi si raffredda e ricade sotto forma di pioggia. Oggi, per ottenere la pioggia, i piloti del servizio meteorologico volano sopra le nuvole e spargono speciali sostanze chimiche che fanno gelare le minuscole gocce di acqua dalle nuvole e le trasformano in pezzetti di ghiaccio così pesanti che cadono. Questo è un libro di testa delle elementari. Stanno saltando una generazione. Per cambiare la storia, loro, la generazione che vive la storia, la negano. Invece ai bambini gliela insegnano in maniera diversa.